Where can they be?
The ball is tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you. Event. Don't mind if I do.
Let's have it.
Maybe. Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been. But still. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone.
Is that trouble? What's that?
Now is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
Please, no more. I surrender. Just let me live.
In this country.
Now for the invitations. What's this? The swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do. Go. Slow down.
What carriage you got there? Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach?
Of course.
Mason. You're not getting off that. Watch it. He's fighting.
I must take care not to ruin the uniform.
Never where you expect to find them. Ah, what's the point? He's not here. Hey, don't move. Look at him there.
Careful. Don't want to get blood on the uniform.
We have an intruder! There!
I hear Mr. Disraeli plans to shun the party.
The man loves being the center of attention.
Keep your eyes open. They are!
Charming. Now to hide the body.
Sorry for that.
Charming. Now to hide the body. Freddy, here I come. One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
You do not want to bother me! She's here! Come on!
Atta girl.
There you are. Miss Fry.
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square. Welcome, sir. Your Highness, what a surprise. Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people.
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily. I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green like? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
No, kill someone!
Easy, girl.
To Parliament, please. On the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
What are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has survived you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you'd like to have them feed you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's rule. My people are treated as slaves. I will die poor 1,000 times over.
Your Highness, what would...
Good day, sir. May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt. But truly, when they took my mother away, I saw her again 2 years before she died.
To the Serbian clubs. straight away.
Disaster avoided his flames and got the alarm removed.
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh.
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your parlor tricks have worn off. Your Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility, and I value your guidance and advice, along with that of Parliament. But it's our burden to rule. Much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it. Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
How you doing, Evie?
A little the worse for wear. Come on.
She's right there! I'm ready to pull the trigger!
Whoa, easy.
Now take a look at what I've made.
If you're pleased, I'll be.
That's a girl. Easy now.
Of course he'd arrive in that.
Miss Fry?
Hand him your weapons. We must enter unarmed. Go on in, sir and madam.
Dear madam, I am soon to become prime minister.
What in the blazes is our carriage doing here?
Did I hear something?
No, just the voices in your own head.
And yet, they are so much more pleasant than yours.
Charming.
Aren't I?
I shall go and find the Peace of Eden.
As you wish. I'm off to meet Freddy.
The plans are located in the white drawing room, which is most likely locked. The captain of the guard will have a key. Do this on my own.
Are fine the way they are.
My dear fellow, that's rough.
Congratulations.
How wonderful.
I can't do this on my own. Keep your mouth closed, and this will be over before you know it.
Who are you? Gentle!
What's going on?
Gracious! Gentle! The lady is with me.
Much obliged.
Madam? Gentle! That hurts! That hurts! Gentle! That hurts! That hurts. That hurts.
Don't get started on politics. It shouldn't come into it.
That hurts. That hurts.
If picketing's been declared illegal, then it's our job to stop it, and that's all there is to it.
That hurts.
There's conservatives and liberals, Whigs and radicals, but just remember...
Gentle!
Don't matter if he's red, white or blue, but the PM...
Surrender!
I'll crush you like a beetle!
The plans are somewhere nearby. Now for the vault. Jacob's most likely off stealing another carriage somewhere, or accidentally pushing the Queen down a flight of stairs.
There you are! I have someone I'm simply dying for you to meet. Come with me! Your Majesty, may I present Miss Evie Fry?
You are the one responsible for Mr. Gladstone's mishap.
Your Majesty, I apologize.
The cake is particularly good. Enjoy the ball.
I really must be going.
Miss Fry, may I have this dance?
Mr. Starrick, you've had your fun, but the game is over.
Listen. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Time is a wonderful thing, Miss Fry. It heals all wounds. We may make mistakes while dancing, but the mazurka ends, and then we begin again. Problem is, everyone forgets. They trip on the same mistakes over and over.
People can learn.
Can they? Isn't everyone around you repeating the same steps? But if one man could remember the dance, could know the time, then he could change things for the better.
I have had enough.
This dance is nearly over. Soon, the people will forget the generation on this terrace. The ruin you nearly wrought on London. When the music ceases, Miss Fry, your time is up. And mine begins.
Thank you.
But Helga wants the child to have a German.